Yo, what's up guys? Welcome back to my channel. Today I have a brand new editing tutorial for you guys. It's going to be this blinking effect. Basically, we're gonna take any solid object or picture and we're gonna animate some blinking into them. This is done in After Effects. It's pretty simple, so let's just jump right into it.
Okay, so we'll open up After Effects. I don't really create a new project. I just kinda exit this screen out. Right now we're in the, let's just go to default. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to grab the clip that I'm going to be using. So right now this is the example. I just named my clip example. So I'm just going to drag it in here. So now let's make this full screen. It'll pop up on my left hand corner. So I'm just going to drag it in right here. So let's just play it real quick. So I just wanted to note that I've already trimmed the clip on what I'm going to use. So I trimmed it in Final Cut Pro. And then I kind of like speed ramped it and then I exported it and I dragged it in here just to let you guys know. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to duplicate the clip. So we're going to do Command D. Now we're going to mute the clip underneath. So we're going to click this little eyeball. Now we're just looking at a clip on top. Now what we're going to do is we're going to draw a mask underneath the eyes. So go to where, let's see, you can go to where you want the effect to start. So I want SpongeBob to start blinking around here. So I'm just going to zoom it in a little bit. 50%, nope. Let me see if it's 100%. Okay, that's good enough. Now we're going to go up here, grab our masking tool. I'm going to zoom in a little bit more. Now I'm going to start drawing a mask underneath the eyes. Okay, let's just mask. Let's invert it real quick. Okay, cool. Let me take this invert. Oh, okay. So now what we're gonna do is we're going to unmute the clip underneath, okay? So as you can see, our masks are moving. So if you get a clip on a tripod and your subject isn't moving, then you won't have to do this. But since my clip is moving, we're going to have to keyframe the mask so they stay on the same spot. So let's go back to where we drew them on. Let's go over here on our left hand side and let's turn on the mask path. I just click all of them, honestly. Doesn't really matter, but so now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go towards the beginning and I'm just gonna move it by the eyeballs. Usually After Effects does a good job of kind of like sticking the mask in the same spot. So it looks like it did a decent job right there. Right here, move it. Dun, dun. Okay. And let's just skip a couple more frames over here. Just double click on it. Move it. And move it. Okay, looks like it did a decent job. Now, of course, if you want a cleaner look, then I would suggest, you know, taking more time on it. But I'm just doing this, you know, so I can speed up the tutorial and not bore you guys. So what we're going to do now is we're going to click on the clip underneath. We're going to go to our effects panels, effects and presets, and we're going to type in Liquify. We're going to go to Liquify. We're going to grab it and we're going to drag it on our clip underneath. Here we go. So here we go. So now you get this little tool. You're going to click this one right here. And then our brush is kind of big. Warp tool options, brush size. We're going to drag it down just a little bit. Okay. Now, before you start using the brush tool, we want to go to where we want the blinking to start. So I believe I wanted it to start right here. Also, I just zoomed it in so I can edit it a little bit better. So let's go back to 200%. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna go and still have the bottom clip clicked. And now we're gonna just start dragging down. Okay, let me go back a little bit. Let me make this bigger, actually. Brush size. Start dragging it down. Down. Okay. Now I'll start dragging this down. So as you can see, the eyes are hiding behind the mask. It doesn't look super good, but... Okay, so once we got the way we want the eyes to look, this isn't perfect, but we're gonna add some more motion blur so it kind of covers it up. What we're gonna do is, let me kind of close this off. We're gonna go down here. Make sure that the bottom clip is still clicked, and then we're gonna go to distortion percentage, and this is where we wanted our blinking to start, so we're just gonna click on it. Actually, let me open this back up again. And our distortion percentage is at 100%, so that means it's gonna blink right around here. So let's go back a little bit. We turned on the distortion percentage, and now we're gonna put 0%. So now it doesn't really do anything. And boom, now we got this little effect where it blinks 0 to 100. And now we can put 0% over here as well. So now it gives it a little blinking look. Well, what you can also do is you can go over here, enable motion blur, click on the little three circles, enable motion blur, and when you export it, it's gonna look a lot smoother. Also, you can try to like make the mask a little bit better. Let's do fit. Also, you can highlight these, go to keyframe assistant, easy ease to help smooth it out, help smooth everything out a little bit, as well as you can also copy these keyframes, command C, and then you can paste them wherever you want, so you don't have to keep redoing the blinking effect. And yeah, this is how you guys do it. Let me know what you guys think. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.